When our father disowned us, I couldn't believe what I was hearing. It wasn't until much later that his words began to sink in that I began to feel the weight of what it meant. Do you remember when the decision was made to come to Sharlyan? Grahas said that the Forum was determined to keep us in the dark, and that Father's venomous performance was part of that strategy, to keep us at arm's length. Perhaps it was. Father argued with Grandfather on many occasions, but never with such dismissive contempt. And when he demanded what justifies the sacrifices we make in war, I honestly didn't know what to say. Neither did Alpha know, I know, but never for one moment did I believe we had made the wrong choice. So all I could do was fume silently. It was only afterwards that I realized how childish I had been, how being stubborn and self-righteous must run in the family. If I could have just mustered a civil response, then things might have turned out differently. They must be ferrying goods to Labyrinthos. A vast complex beneath the island. Sharlyan is famous for archiving knowledge from around the world. Well, that knowledge is not preserved exclusively in dusty tomes and desiccated samples. Our living library, comprised of all manner of flora and fauna, is housed and studied within that underground facility. Still, that did seem to be an unusually large shipment. When I lived here, it was rare to even see such cargo transported by boat. Wait! Didn't you hear something in the last stand about the gleaners coming and going more than usual? Well, I think they're the ones we saw manning those boats. And gleaners answer to the Forum. If the appearance of the Telophoroi prompted this sudden burst of activity, then Labyrinthos may hold a clue as to what the Forum is planning.
Thank you. Deep beneath the scholar's city shines a false sun within a fabricated sky. In any age exist those who consider the floor an extension of their bookshelves. And this vault's architects surely belonged to that special breed. If the stack grows too high, start a new one. If no room remains, then make more rooms. A simple solution at first, and then bit by bit, a profound transformation. Knowledge buried beneath knowledge, a growing, creeping labyrinth from which there is no escape.
Expected.
I must admit, the artifice is very convincing. But I assure you that we are beneath Sharlyan itself. The breeze you feel, the flowing waters you hear, all created by the hand of man.
The island is volcanic, you see, and once upon a time, this great hollow must have been a reservoir for magma. It was discovered some 400 years ago. At which point it was repurposed as a storage facility for scrolls and samples and such. Renovations have continued, with nigh on no interruption to this day, with the lower levels still undergoing expansion.
Aren't those people gleaners?
Aye, judging by their dress. They are said to work alone as a rule, but 'twould seem that rule is being enthusiastically broken today. It may be as you suspected, that they are engaged in a task apart from the norm.
Let's spread out and get some answers then.
Did you call to me just now? No. How odd. I must be a bit dizzy from the descent. I'll be fine, I'm sure. Let's get to work, shall we?
Fair shot. Nicely done. Let me truss this one up and I'll make my way over to you.
There you are. Any new revelations?
So you met with that gleaner again, this time to capture a hornbill. I understand catching and bringing in creatures from the outside, but what's the point of chasing after ones already here?
Oh, it's a simple thing, really. Occasionally, we remove specimens no longer needed for study, or those we've had difficulty raising. But we can't simply turn them loose. Safely returning such creatures to their native habitats is another facet of a gleaner's duties. But not in this case, I'm afraid. I've been asked to bring the bird below.
The restricted section in the lower levels of Labyrinthos. Open only to a select few researchers hand-picked by the Forum. The projects down there are the subject of rumor and hearsay. Forbidden magics. Advanced technologies that can never be allowed to fall into outside hands. Even Archons are not privy to the truth. Those who are, the researchers involved in this secretive work, are not permitted to walk freely in the city, and are instead required to live in isolated quarters.
What could a facility subject to such strict security protocols possibly need with a hornbill? An experiment?
Possibly. I wasn't afforded an explanation. But judging by the requisition list given to me and my colleagues, I doubt it's for any kind of advanced research. I'd be more inclined to believe we were making preparations to migrate to the south. Meresidia or thereabouts.
What? Why would you say that?
Much of the flora and fauna we were asked to procure could serve as reliable sources of sustenance. They're comparatively hardy species, too. Able to endure harsh climates. And among them are specimens known to be effective in improving soil quality and purifying water.
When you put it that way, migration does sound like a reasonable assumption.
That's all it is, though. An assumption. Through our tasks, we gleaners glimpse only bits and pieces of the Forum's plans. Our prime concern is that our requisitions, be they living or otherwise, are properly preserved for the knowledge of future generations. Now, I really must be going. I regret that I cannot reward you as you deserve.
Perhaps you might reward us after a fashion then. It is imperative that we reach the lower levels. And seeing as you are already set to descend with your assigned cargo, mayhap we could accompany you as your assistants.
I'm afraid that won't be possible. Once the animals have been prepared for transport, we send them down separately via the lift. I will, of course, follow after to make my report, but I can hardly pass you off as porters when there's nothing left to carry.
Indeed. Pray forget I said anything.
How do you feel about climbing? If you've strength and the courage to brave it, then there is another way down. This path leads to the 33rd facet. A mine shaft excavated during one of our expansions of Labyrinthos. While I cannot guarantee that the passage is safe to traverse, it should provide access to the medial circuit below.
I never never even knew such a place existed. Thank you. This is the perfect solution.
You're quite welcome. But consider yourselves warned. If the going proves too treacherous, you'd do well to turn back. I bid you good day.
Well, turning back is hardly an option, not when we've come this far. Let's go and take a look at this mineshaft.